at the Revel. You know, I'm not doing the whole Fat Man Scoop thing, although I could, but, you know, tell people what it's going to be like and all that good stuff.
Well, next Saturday night, January 18th, from 10 p.m. to 4 a.m. at Revel Casino Hotel. They changed the name, Revel Casino Hotel's Ovation Hall. We will have the 2014 Marty Small Ball. And this year, I decided to add a twist and a theme, and it's called the Mardi Gras Masquerade Experience. And
oh,
it's not
okay.
The Mardi Gras, not M-A-R-D-I.
It's the Marty.
It's M-A-R-T-Y. But,
okay.
You know, what you want to see, we're going to try to give it that New Orleans feel, you know, a bunch of beads in the place, you know, masks. As a matter of fact, we have a contest. The male and female with the best masks will receive a 3-day, 2-night vacation. And, you know, we're just going to have a good time. The bottom line is there's not a lot, you know, of entertainment that, you know, cater to urban Atlantic City. And I don't have a problem saying that. And, you know, when I do my two events a year, you know, the community comes out and support. And more importantly, you know, we bring in people from all over. I mean,
yeah.
We read articles in the paper about the doom and gloom of Atlantic City. We need to bring non-gaming entertainment. Hey, if I can do it, it shouldn't matter if I'm a councilman or not. So, you know, we're bringing people in from all over. We have buses coming from Washington, D.C. Shout out to my man, Wally K., Mr. Miami. We have people coming in from all over, and we're going to make an impact on the economy next week. You know, Revel will be sold out. You know, people are coming in town at other casino hotels, and it's going to be a good weekend in addition to, you know, my event. The next morning, we have a big brunch at Kelsey's, and that night, Platinum Production out of Philadelphia is putting on All Stars of Hip Hop show.
Oh, that's Sunday night,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, Boardwalk Hall with E, Fat Joe, Ice Cube,
right.
Dougie Fresh, EU, and others. So
yeah, Dougie, I mean, Ice Cube on the East Coast,
yeah.
That's big. That's,
yeah. And DJ Cool, too.
Yeah,
so let me clear my throat.
Okay.
Yeah, but, you know, I mean, I'm just looking forward to the next weekend. It's going to be a lot of people in town. It's a holiday weekend. It's Martin Luther King weekend. And, you know, we're just going to have a good time. And, you know,
right.
It's going to be special.
Okay, so let's rewind a little bit. Why the twist this year? I mean, man, you seen the pictures. I wasn't the only one doing my thing at the ball last year, man. So
well,
why'd you decide to add I'm not complaining,
well,
but, you know, why'd you decide to add the New Orleans Mardi Gras flavor to it?
I've been sitting on this thing, you know, for a minute, and you know, I look at it, I didn't theme the ball last year. You know, my last theme ball was a couple years ago when we did the Boardwalk Empire. But,
okay.
You know, this is different. Masks are required.
Okay.
You know, you can't get in the door without a mask on.
Okay.
And if you don't come with a mask, there'll be masks available for purchase. We're dealing with a local vendor. And like I said, it's just about, you know, creating opportunities for, you know, the economy, and it's definitely going to do that because, you know, people are going to go out and buy their outfit, they're going to go out and buy their mask, they're going to go out and, you know, get their hair done, their nails done, so everybody's going to benefit. The people at the casino are going to get tips, and, you know, the casino is going to be jumping, and I'm just looking forward to it. And, you know, like I said, I decided to theme this year's ball since we didn't do last year, so it's, you know, a lot of people are excited because it's different and it's something new.
Oh, okay, how'd you make out with the white party? I think that was the last time you were here with us, just before the party.
No, the white party was at the Taj Mahal this summer. It was
yeah.
a success. we had a great time.
I had a ball.
That's why we say, man, we don't throw parties, we throw events.
Right, right. If you're just tuning in, you're listening to Weekend South Jersey. My special guest here today is Councilman Marty Small. So it's not the Small Ball this year, it's the Mardi Gras?
No, the official title is the 2014 Marty Small Ball, the Mardi Gras Masquerade Experience. And shout out, you know, to all my followers on Instagram. If you listen to Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter, if you're listening right now, leave a comment that you're listening.
Okay. That's great. So, who do you have on tap to provide the music this year? Because that's always a big big part of the event as well.
Well, this summer we featured the legendary, the diabolical DJ Biz Markie.
Right, right.
But this time, You know, we keeping it like local. We have from the DC area. He's a part of Core DJs, DJ Casper.
Okay.
We have Mr. Atlantic City DJ 5D.
Okay.
And Power 99's own DJ Doc B.
Doc B.
Doc B's in the house.
That's what's up.
You'll be dancing to the tunes of them. We also have other entertainment as well. I'm not going to give too much up, but it's going to be a different experience.
It's going to be a different experience.
It's going to be very nice.
Okay, classic. So the event is taking place Saturday night, Revels Ovation Hall.
Yes.
And it's the 2014 Marty Small Ball, the Mardi Gras.
Masquerade experience.
The Mardi Gras masquerade experience.
So you know what that means.
You got to wear a mask.
You have to wear a mask, too.
I have to wear a mask, too.
Even as a member of the media. Go.
Hey, listen, man. I got a question for you, because I was checking that out. Are you going to have beads there, or do I have to bring my own beads? Are you going to be selling beads, or what's happening with that?
Earn your beads as you must.
Oh, man. Okay. So, yeah. Well, one thing I can say is, you know, I always mess with the Marty small parties. Besides being
Excuse me. You committed a faux pas on air.
Okay.
It's not the Marty small party.
Experiences, no, events.
Because we don't throw parties. We throw events.
Okay. One thing I want to say is I always see your events as homecomings. I see people there who a lot of times I haven't seen them, Atlantic City residents or natives who I haven't seen since the last small event.
Yeah.
So, you know, and that's one thing that I'm always proud of, that you're able to get people to come back home and to, since I can't use the word party, can I say soiree? To soiree in peace.
I would ask you to be the responsible journalist that you are and speak events.
To event in peace.
Yes.
Talk to me about that. I mean, are you proud of that? That people, you know, look for this as like two of the biggest social events of the year, and B, that so many people feel, I don't want to say obligated, but they ain't going, like me, you know, every time I know that this is coming up, you know, I call you early and say we need to get you in here, you know, so people don't feel obligated, but they like, I'm not missing this.
No, well, I mean, you know, everything isn't for everybody, just like in life. And,
right,
you know, you have some people who don't want to attend for whatever reason. And, you know, I'm not going to get to that, but let's talk about the people who do want to attend every year. That's what I was going to say. You know. I mean, and you have people that want to attend because, you know, truth be told, it's something that we have to look forward to. And
right,
like I said, you know, there's not a lot of urban entertainment, you know, in the city lately, if you pay attention to what's going on.
Right.
And I'm happy to be able to provide that. And, you know, because of my connections and, you know, resources and networking, you know, beyond Atlantic City, we've been able to get a lot of people from all over to embrace the event.
Right. And, you know, that's one thing you talked about, reaching out beyond Atlantic City, that I've been trying to get people from Atlantic City to understand, is that we do need events that put Atlantic City like on the world stage. You know, along with the, you know, the events that you have every year, one of the things that I really admired about Mayor Langford and some other people were doing with the Summer in the City concerts, it was making Atlantic City a destination that people had to come to. And if you look at other cities, not even as major as ours, cities like Charlotte, they have the CIAA tournament. Atlanta has the National Black Arts Festival, and they have different festivals and things every year that bring people from around the world to their city, and we, you know, Atlantic City definitely needs that. Just before you got here, I was on the phone with the people from Atlantic City Fashion Week. Another thing that's going to bring people from as far away as Australia. They have designers coming from Australia to come to Atlantic City for a weekend, and I'm gonna ask you to speak for some of the people who don't get Marty Small right now. Do you know why they don't get the Marty Small, the annual Marty Small ball is a big deal and it's important and it needs to be supported and people need to get behind you and make this thing as big as it can be for all of us.
I mean, it's simple in my book. I mean, people are closed-minded. They think because I hold an official title that, you know, I can't still, you know, provide entertainment, when the truth is, every councilman that's currently sitting in the seat, we all have other jobs. I mean, I work for the school system. I run after-school sports. So, you know, that's my full-time. I mean, legislatively, per Title 40, we consider it part-time, but we all know it's more of a full-time responsibility. But at the end of the day, we're not going to be in office forever, and people have to understand that. And I've always been involved in promotions some way, shape, or form since I was a kid. So this is a natural to me. Just like with the movies, a lot of people were closed-minded and ignorant to the fact, saying, oh, well, why is he doing movies?
I got a problem with your latest movie, right?
This place right here is where I went to school at.
Okay.
You know, I'm an alumni of the Rich and Stockton College of New Jersey. Also, I was a communications major, so I was doing movies, commercials, you know, all of that when I was in school. I just, you know, got with a fine, filmmaker out of Philadelphia, and, you know, we started, you know, just doing things outside of the box. Yeah. We didn't do a movie this time.
Oh,
People's disappointment, because the holidays, we had, you know, conflict with cast and, you know, everything. Gotcha. But we're loading up for a big one in the summer. But we just did a little, you know, promotional video. But,
yeah,
you know, like I said, people just need to open up their minds. On one hand, you know, people say when you get in position, you know, they don't want you to change, so to speak. They want you to, you know, be who you are, because that's the first thing somebody says, oh, well, he's getting new. But, you know, when I still stay true to my roots and things that I've done, as well as serving the people, you know, doing these events twice a year doesn't hurt my home life, it doesn't hurt my work life, and it doesn't hurt what I do as a councilman. I'm always there for my people.